We're in the catacombs of Gamescom 2014 to take a look at Assassin's Creed. Hello, I'm Aoife Wilson, and I'm coming to you from Cologne, Germany for Gamescom 2014. And joining me now is Vincent Pontbriand from Ubisoft, who's going to take us back in time to the French Revolution so we can chat about Assassin's Creed Unity. Vincent, how are you?
I'm very good, thank you.
Awesome. Now, the single-player campaign looks incredible. So can you tell us a little bit about the changes that you've made to the series?
We've completely overhauled our technology in order to bring this new shared experience. We've changed all the graphics, all the systems, the crowd mechanics, the interactions. Still feels like an Assassin's Creed, but it feels like it's renewed completely.
Because, I mean, the crowds before were in their hundreds, and now they're well over the thousands,
right? Thousands, yes.
The changes that next-gen can enable you guys to make, what other sort of examples of that are there?
More power helps us having more NPCs on screen. That's one thing. We wanted to have not only more NPCs, but smarter NPCs on screen. So the crowd interacts with itself as well. So Sif just happens in the background without player interactions.
Now, the map looks so huge. How much bigger would you say it is than previous installments? Because there is more interior space now as well, right?
I'm one of those guys that don't think that size matters, but... the map is huge, it's very big. In terms of landmass, it's bigger than all the islands from the previous AC Black Flag combined together. So that's our Paris. What's different this year is that we're allowing players to visit Paris inside out. So we have seamless interiors, we have all these big landmarks. So a lot of surface area, a lot of things to explore.
So tell us a little bit more about the seamless indoor-outdoor transitions, because that sounds like it's going to add loads to the free running and the parkour.
This is a game changer. It changes the paradigm of navigation. So AC was always about like freedom and open world and stuff, but it was still in Hollywood set. It was like just an empty cardboard set. And now with the seamless interiors, you can go inside out, you'll find, you know, people there living, doing their stuff.
So let's chat a little bit about Arno, our main protagonist. How customizable is he? Because obviously everyone's going to have their own version of him now.
Exactly. Although the main character is a narrative character, he's basically very open to customization. So it's not only just the gear, or the visuals, I should say. It's the weapons, it's the skills. So as players progress, they'll branch off in different paths. So one player could choose to go down the stealth path, while the other one will choose like more combat skills, for example.
Let's chat a little bit about the new weapons. I've got my eye on the Phantom Blade, which looks kind of cool, right?
Yeah. So we have a few variations of the Phantom Blades and a few other surprises in the game.
Oh, really? Yeah. Not going to tell us about any of those right now, are you?
I shouldn't.
Well, Vincent, thank you so much.
My pleasure.
I cannot wait to start stalking the streets of Paris. Keep checking back throughout the week because we've got loads more exclusive content coming to you direct from Gamescom 2014.